Hi everybody, I'm Theo. If you're seeing this video, you probably already know me, as my audience is hopefully people that already know me, because I don't do anything super exciting. I don't know how to edit, I don't have a microphone, I'm just out here. And I realized I play on a server that none of my friends have access to, and I thought instead of pestering them every time I call them, I might as well just make a little YouTube series about what I do. That would be a lot easier. I know some basic editing. I can talk to a camera. I got some cool mods that make it viewable and pretty. And I've been watching Hermitcraft for 2 years. Hopefully, I can imitate them correctly, considering that I play ScarWorld. You can see Queen Jelly behind me, standing by the flag. I don't have a script. I just thought I'd like vlog, I guess, do video vlogs of what I do with my too much time on Minecraft, so that you understand what kind of person I am. Now you might notice I have a very nice abode here, and I've already built some things, because I've been playing on the server for about 4 months. Someone yesterday said about 7 months, and then that really hurt me, because I realized I've only built this house, the house next door, a couple paths, and then that's it. I didn't really plan much. However, I did uncover last night a Pinterest board I made, and I realized that the ideas I put in that Pinterest board have a lot more pizzazz than what I have come up with after forgetting about the fact that I made a Pinterest board. So I feel like my project here, my lovely— oh, I should sleep. Alright, good morning everyone. Where even was I? I forgot what I was talking about. Oh right, Pinterest boards, pizzazz. Yeah, I wanna actually make this project in this area a lot better than it currently is. I only have some bare bones ideas. You know, I made a house, got a house, I got a ranch because I decided to dedicate myself into selling goat horns. Not a good business plan. It's funny, not— I've earned no diamonds from doing this. Something I want to know, if you are seeing this in a reasonable time frame and you have a spare, like, $15, you can donate, you can become a patron for Good Times with Scar, and join me. You can join me. On the first of every month, they let in new users, so you can come say hi. I'd probably gladly help you with your own base, because I love helping people with their bases, because it allows me to procrastinate on my own. I made the series so I'd stop doing that, but you know, old habits die hard. I'm going to tell you a little bit about this project I'm working on, since I never elaborated, and some people might not know that. I wanted to make a town. I've tried to make a town several times in the past. I only get about half, you know, to this stage. And then I stop, and this stage is being, I have a house, I made another house to put other things in, and I made some pathways, and I have a general idea of where I want an industrial district to go, and a residential district. And that's it. That's all I got. And then I never sit down and put in the hours to design a million buildings to put in the area, because I am very indecisive, and I don't like committing to things. But maybe if I think that, you know, I'll be a fun little YouTuber, it will motivate me to put in more effort, since I don't have anything else going on. And that leads us to today's issue. For our lovely friend OceanFlan, here's a little plushie made by Maisie Crafter, or Mozzie Crafter. I sure remember how to pronounce that name. Nonetheless, my friend OceanFlan told me that I need to make a fountain. Because I asked him, what do I make? Because I have so many ideas, and I can't decide on one. And he told me to make a fountain. And I made a fountain. But the problem is that it sucked. So, I tore it down. And now I have this lovely little square. With some, clean up this litter here. Got a lovely little square, and I have a dedicated spot for a fountain to go. Ideally, once this is done, we'll have this nice fountain, and then this huge square that people can, like, set up little stands in, and this is, like, their little market where they hang out and they do little performances, because it's lovely, a bustling community that is definitely not Definitely not just me and all the goats. Something I want to point out is that I put a lovely little star design here because I like these four-pointed stars. The reason I like these four-pointed stars is because I saw them all the time in Genshin Impact, and I like the style and design of Genshin Impact, and so I decided to cop their four-pointed stars. Something else I wanted to note is that I made this little design inspired by the designs I saw in Scarland. I thought that was pretty cool that you combined, you know, different blocks to make designs and pavement. And I made this using MS Paint. I just zoom in real far and each pixel is a block and I can make any shape I want. The primary thing here is that I want this fountain to not be gray. We already have all this andesite and all this stone brick, and honestly, gray is one of my least favorite colors. It's a nice neutral, it binds everything else together. However, if I have too much gray, it's very boring, I don't like it. So I think I want to make this fountain, first of all, not gray, and second of all, not your traditional fountain. I've seen a lot of different fountain shapes, and I want to do something a little bit different. Just because I think if I make a normal three-tiered fountain or two-tiered fountain, it'd be pretty lame. I'm off to Pinterest to go find a cool sign. I can see where I was trying to go with this. I just think it needs a little more shaping. A little more shaping would probably fix it. This has a satisfactory amount of wonk to it. Considering that I have to work with a 2-block wide center, many fountains tend to have a 1-block wide center, and if you are a builder like me, that's pretty important. So I decided to end it up on 1 block, but it's crooked. But this is, as Greenwood wisely put it, a good amount of wonk.
Now, these two were actually a little bit too straight, so I added a little bit of wonk. That's weird. It's a weird thing.
Last thing I have to do is put some plants in it, some lights on it, and some water in it. So, final touches, and I think it'll work out nice. I think it'll be nice. There we go. That is not what I wanted to happen. You know, this is the first time I've ever had a wandering sheep trader come in, so I'm pretty excited about this. I am a huge fan of mini blocks, and I really want to get all of these before he vanishes on me, so I should probably take a good note about what's here. And it definitely won't take me about 7 different trips. Look at that, it's finished. I did a take of this already and I forgot I left my mic muted. Truly, really good at this game. Really good at this whole video making thing. I added some plants on top, and there's a lantern on top, because I like putting lanterns on top of fences. I think it looks a little fun, a little silly. I like the wonk, and we got this flowing water down into this pool. I feel like I did some sort of spell so the water is recirculating. I think this is, you know, more of a fountain than a well. I don't think people would draw their water think they would throw in little coins or pieces of nuggets of gold and stuff. I quite like it. I like the brick. I like the tile. I like the wood. I think it's a good fountain, and I sure hope that OceanFlan likes it, because I made this fountain for him. more for me, less for him, but still nonetheless for him. Isn't that gorgeous? I think it looks amazing. I love it. Got the vines swinging in the wind. We're gonna get some blueberries growing here very soon. I think all that's left to do is, well, everything else. I started editing this video and I realized how much I talk. I talk a lot. So I think that's all I might do for today. I got other stuff to do. See you around.